Hello guys, so today in this video I am going to talk about the value of acceleration due to gravity. So today in this video we are gonna see the derivation relating to the acceleration due to gravity, and we will see some of the places where the value of acceleration due to gravity varies. So this video is going to be little bit longer than our previous videos, so keep watching to know more about this topic. Okay, so let's start. Okay, first of all we are gonna see the derivation. Okay, so what I have written here, let m is the mass of earth and r is its radius. Let us consider the condition of earth. Okay, m is the mass of earth and r is the radius of earth. So let a small body m, okay, let a small body of mass m is dropped from certain height, then the gravitational force acting on the body can be written as, obviously this is the formula, right? Like when we talked about two bodies of masses m1 and m2, then we used F is equal to g m1 dot m2 by t square, right? But right now I'm talking about the earth, I'm talking about the earth and a mass placed on it. Okay, so we are gonna take the radius of the earth. As the radius of the body is very small, so that can be neglected. Okay, so Newton's universal gravitational law becomes this. So as well as we know that the gravitational force is equals to the weight of the body, and which is equal to m into g, this formula, right? We have already talked about this formula. So we are gonna equate equation 1 and 2. By equating equation 1 and 2, we get this form, g is equal to gm bar square. In this form, m and m has been cancelled out. Okay, so this is the value for the acceleration due to gravity. Okay, this is the value for the acceleration due to gravity of the earth. By using this formula, we can actually calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity of the earth and any other planet if we know the value of radius and mass of that planet. Okay, so for earth, the mass of the earth is 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg, and radius of the earth is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter. Then the acceleration due to gravity can be written as gm by r square. Okay, if we put the value of g, capital M and r square, then we will get the value 9.8 meter per second, and this is the value we use for the numerical purposes, right? So this was the derivation relating to the value of acceleration due to gravity, and this is the formula that we need to remember. Now we are gonna see some of the places where the value of the acceleration due to gravity varies. Okay, so let's see now the variation of acceleration due to gravity. So first place is variation due to radius of the earth. Okay, see, this is the condition variation due to radius of the earth. Okay, like as the radius of the earth changes, the value of acceleration due to gravity also changes. Why? See here, the value of acceleration due to gravity was g is equal to gm by r square. Now g and m are constant terms, that's why they can be eliminated. So if we eliminate them, we need to convert the equal to sign to proportionality sign. So by this equation, what do we see? G and r are inversely proportional to each other. That means if r increases, g will decrease, and if r decreases, g will increase. Okay, so this is the reason why the value of g is more at poles where the earth is flattened and less at equator where the earth is bulged. Okay, so this is the numerical value. The value of g at poles is equal to 9.83. this is slightly more than 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, and the value of g at equator is 9.78 meter per second square. This is slightly less than 9.8 meter per second square, the normal value that we use. Okay, so from this we can see that the value of acceleration due to gravity depends on radius of the earth also, right? So for the next condition, let's see variation due to height from the earth surface. Okay, as we increase the height of the mass or decrease the height of the mass, the value of acceleration due to gravity will change. Okay, here also I have written the same thing. Let m and r are the mass and radius of the earth. Let a body of mass small m is kept at the height h from the earth surface. Okay, so as we can see on this figure, this is the earth, this is the small mass m, that can be anything, okay, or stone or a big stone, anything, a ball, anything. So if we see this, let us consider r as the radius of the earth and this h is the height of this thing, this small mass from the earth surface, okay, this h which we have considered to be small h. Okay, so the new radius, as we can say radius, or let's say distance of the body, center of the body from the center of the earth, becomes r plus h. Now in place of r, we can write r plus h, the new gravitational force. The formula for gravitational force becomes gmm by r plus h to the power, sorry, whole square, right? Now again we know that gh be the acceleration due to gravity at the height h. Okay, at the height h, let us consider the value of acceleration due to gravity is gh. Okay, then the force will be F is equal to m into gh, right? Force means weight. This is the formula, this will be the formula. Now from equation 1 and 2, I have considered equation, we can see here, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. We can equate equation 1 and 2. These two are F, so their right hand side will be also equal. See here, m into g into h, actually this is, this h is the base, okay, this h is the base, this is not mgh which is the formula for potential energy, this mg and h in the base, okay, which is equal to gmm by r plus h whole square. Again m and m can be cancelled out and we can get this formula. Similarly g and m are constant terms, so we can eliminate them, and if we eliminate them, we need to convert this equal to sign to proportionality sign, that we have done here, right? Sorry, I've missed something. This is square, this is square. So as I have done this here, now see here, hence the value of g decreases with increase in h. Now if we increase in h, the value of g will decrease, and vice versa. That means if we decrease the value of h, the value of acceleration due to gravity will increase. Okay, now let's see the third condition, third and last condition, variation with depth from the earth surface. Variation with depth from the earth surface. Now if we dig out, if we dig our earth and if we put something to a in a depth d, and if we measure the distance, if we measure the acceleration due to gravity, then there will be certain change in the acceleration due to gravity. So what changes do we get? Okay, let us derive the formula. So again the same thing, let us consider the let us consider a figure whose radius is r, and this new if we decrease the radius of the earth by the depth d, okay, so let us consider the distance that we have dig to be d. Okay, let m and r are the mass and radius of earth. Let a body of mass m be kept at the depth d from the surface of the earth, then r will be r minus d, right? The new radius will be r minus d. So from Newton's law, F will be equal to gmm by r minus d whole square, right? In place of r, we can write r minus d to the power whole square. Now the acceleration due to gravity, the force or weight will be equal to m into gd. Now if we equate equation 1 and 2, the right hand side will be equal, because the left hand side are F in both the equation, right? So the new formula will be gd equal to gm by r minus d whole square. Again if we eliminate g and d, this equal to sign will change to proportionality sign. That means we will get a value like this, gd inversely proportional to r minus d to the power whole square, right? Therefore from this equation, if we notice that if we decrease the value of d, the value of g will increase, and if we increase the value of d, the value of g will be decreased. So this is the condition. This is also very important question for SEE examination. So I hope you guys understood it. So if you like my video, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. Thank you.